Okay, my dear students, welcome to your English class. For this class, we are going to have a review about some topics. So we are going to have a review about some grammar too. So please, everybody go to this page and I'm going to ask to Andrea, can you please help me to read the instructions? Complete, thank you.
Complete the next with the past, no sé qué dice ahí porque no veo.
Past simple.
Past simple. No sé si dice algo más.
No se nota, en serio. Vaya, entonces no. Espérame, lo vamos a corregir ahorita. Uy, pero se me van a mover las respuestas. Ok, lo leo yo, no te preocupes. Complete the text with the past simple form of the verbs in the box. Hoy sí, Andrea, leamos los verbos. Thank you. Live.
Life, invent, work, go, use, start, want, make, change, be.
Be. En este caso, el ejercicio me pide que primero que nada voy a pasar los verbos a pasado. Por ejemplo, en el caso de live, tengo lived, que en este caso es con ed, porque es un verbo regular. ¿Cuál sería el pasado de invent? ¿Cómo lo paso a pasado? I invent, yo invento, pero si yo quiero decir yo inventé, es un verbo regular. Ajá.
Invent.
Invent.
Invent. Thank you. Welcome, Christian. Work. How can I pass into past?
Work.
Work.
Work. Okay. ED. Go.
Went.
Went. Excellent. Use. It's a regular verb. Use.
Use.
Use. Yes. ED. Start.
Start.
Start. Excellent. Want.
Want.
Wanted. Okay. ED. Make. Aquí sí. Verbo irregular cambia su estructura. ¿Cómo lo paso pasado? Make.
Made.
Made. Okay. Solo una alumna tengo hoy. Change. ¿Cómo lo paso pasado? Change.
Change.
Change. ED. Igual. Okay. Y en el caso de be. Cuidado porque be es con el verbo to be. ¿Cómo pasó el verbo be a pasado? Hay dos formas.
Was or were.
Was y were. Muy bien, excelente. Ok. For a revolution in manufacturing. Hoy vamos a practicar un poquito de lectura. En este caso va a ser medio, no se preocupen. Dice Henry Ford was born in Dearborn, Michigan in 1863. He lived in a farming area and he went to a small local school. When he was young, he was very interested in machines. This wasn't very common at the time because farmers used animals for work. Henry Ford worked for the Edison Company and in the... Okay, vale. Okay, thank you. Perdón, ahí. For the Edison Company. And in the evenings, he worked in a small garage. He wanted to make a car. In 1896, he made his first car. From 1896 to 1905, Henry Ford produced about 10 to 15 cars. These cars were very expensive. In 1912, Ford was producing cars for $600. This was very cheap and many people bought his cars. This completely changed American society as a new generation of younger people started to travel more. Using special manufacturing techniques, Ford started mass production. As a result, by 1914, they invent over half a million Ford cars in America. Christian, can you please help me to read from Henry Ford to his first car? Thank you.
Okay. Henry Ford was born in Dearborn, Michigan. In 1863, he lived in a farming area and he went to a small local school. When he was young, he was very interested in machines. This was not very common at the time because farmers used animals for work. Henry Ford worked for the Edison Company, and in the evenings, he worked in a small garage. He wanted to make a car. In 1896, he made his first car.
Thank you. Perfect. Christian, can you please help me to choose the next victim? Genesis, Mari, Andrea. Thank you. Choose one.
Andrea.
Okay, Andrea, please. The second paragraph. From 1896. Thank you.
From 1896 to 1905, Henry Ford produce about 10 to 15 cars. These cars were very expensive. In 1912, Ford was producing cars for $600. This was very cheap, and many people bought his cars. This completely changed American
generation
of younger people start to travel more using special manufacturing
techniques.
For a start mass production. As a result, by 1914, their invent over half a million Ford cars and in America.
Andrea, please choose one. Genesis, Mari, or Walter?
Walter.
Okay. Vale, please let me know when you're ready. Okay, Walter, please, can you help me to read the first paragraph? Thank you.
Okay. Henry Ford was born in Dearborn, Michigan in 1963.
He had lived
in a farming area, and he went to a small local school. When he was young, he was very interested in machines. This was not very common at the time because farmers used animals for work. Henry Ford worked for the Edison Company. And in the evening, he worked in a small garage. He wanted to make a car. In 1896, he made his first car.
Stop. Walter, please choose the next one. Genesis, Mary, Rachel, or Valeria?
Mary.
Okay, thank you. Mari, right? Okay, Mari. Okay. Hi, Mari. Can you please help me to read the second paragraph? Con usted termino esta dinámica. Go ahead, please.
Okay. From 1896 to 1905, Henry Ford produced about 10 to 15 cars. These cars were very expensive. In 1912, Ford was producing cars for $600. This way, very cheap, and many people bought these cars. This completely changed American society as a new generation of younger people started to travel more, using special manufacturing techniques for start mass production. As a result, by 1914, they're inventing over half a million Ford cars in America.
In America. So, Mari, I got a question. Se prepara Christian. Do you like to read in English or do you prefer to read in Spanish?
No, I actually I like in English because I think so the pronunciation is better for me, or maybe in my mind I try to traduction the words, and in this case I try to traduce the old paragraph or the old text.
Okay, detallito. Translate, para así traducir. Okay, so, do you have any favorite topic to read, or do you like to read in general?
Maybe no, I don't like real text for words, technical words, or for example this paragraph because this paragraph have a many words, the different pronunciation, different the different thing, but I don't know, I don't like this type of topics.
Yeah. Okay. Excellent. Thank you, Mari. Christian, what about you? Se prepara Walter. In your personal opinion, do you like to read in English or do you prefer to read in Spanish?
I like both, but I prefer English for improve my English, right? And sometimes I practice with reading magazines about technologies because it's good for me, for the university, for my, I don't know, my,
for your career too, right?
Yeah, for my career. And
so, excuse me,
for
Christian.
Practice with a robotic arm.
Wow, yeah. Nice, excellent. Excuse me, what do you do, Christian, when you don't understand a word? What do you
I do? Translate the word in Google.
Oh, nice. Do you have any favorite dictionary on Google, or it doesn't matter?
It doesn't matter. Always I translate with the Google Translate.
Okay, nice. Excellent. Thank you so much. Walter, the same question. What about you? Do you like to read in English or do you prefer to read in Spanish?
Well, I like to read in both. I like to read books in Spanish and I like to read books in English, but for English, I like to read like comics or manga.
Mm-hmm. Oh, good.
Because usually in English, they came first. So I like to read also books about technology because the books that are in Spanish usually are very desfasados. How do you say
desfasados?
So it's better to read these books in English.
Oh, okay. So I got another question, excuse me.
Yes.
So in your opinion, do you prefer to read online or do you prefer to have physic books?
I like physic books.
Okay, why?
Yeah, because, for example, I like physic books, but these books are usually about ocio. I don't know what you say.
Yes, it is.
So, but I when I have to spend money for books about technology, these books, I usually download the PDF.
Ah, okay, nice. Mm-hmm.
But I have some problems because in the computer, usually it's more difficult to pay attention.
So, really?
For me, yes, I have that problem.
Well, it is so possible with me because I don't like to have fancy books because I don't have a space in my room. So I prefer to download the PDF or just to read it online.
Okay. Yeah. I prefer the physical books because I can go to the Amaka.
Oh, yes. The Hancock.
Hancock.
Yeah. Amaka.
And I like the smell of the new books. And I don't know. I think it's better.
Okay. Physics. Okay. Okay. Excellent. That's it?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, thank you so much, Walter. Okay, let's continue. Obviamente voy a sacar una plática dependiendo del ejercicio que vayamos haciendo. Recuerde que el libro ya lo terminamos y solamente estamos haciendo un review de gramática. So, I got a question. Rachel, are you working, Rachel? No?
No.
Okay. Excellent. Rachel, excuse me, do you remember the use of was and where?
Was is third person and where is we,
they,
and I forget
you. Okay, excellent. Yes, it is. Congratulations. Nice. So the letter A, Rachel, me ayudas con la respuesta de la letra B. Voy agarrando uno por uno. Letter A. He was in London yesterday. O sea, él estuvo. He was in London yesterday. Rachel, letter B. Se prepara Valeria con la letra C.
In 2005, we were 11 years old.
Okay, in 2005 or in 2005, we were 11 years old. Valeria, letter C. Se prepara Genesis con la letra D. Mm. By the way, the letter is a question. So, was or where?
Were there a book on the chair?
Okay, book. This is singular book. Or it is plural?
Singular. Is okay. What?
Excellent. Was there a book? Así como que había un libro. So, singular is was. Was there a book on the chair? Excellent, thank you. Genesis, please, letter D, se prepara Andrea con la letra E.
My last computer was a Dell.
Perfect, la marca, muy bien. My last computer was a Dell. Thank you. Letter E, who has letter E? Andrea, right? Yes. Can you please, Christian, nos preparamos con la letra F.
Where? You yesterday?
Excellent. Where were you yesterday? Teacher, what's the difference between this one and this one? The pronouns. This one is more deepest. Were. And this is more simple. Where? Where were you yesterday? Thank you, Andrea. Letter F, Christian se prepara. Yes. Marce, excuse me. Marce, are you working or not? Please let me know. If you're busy, please let me know. 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, don't worry about it. Mari, nos preparamos con la letra
A. Yes, I am working.
Okay, are you able to participate or not?
Right now, yes.
Okay, Mari, pausa entonces. Marce, ¿me ayudas con la letra G? Mari, con la letra H, por favor. Excuse me, Christian, please, continue.
Don't worry. Okay, we were in class yesterday.
Perfect. We were in class yesterday. This is plural. Okay, letter G, Marce, se prepara Mari con la letra H.
The library was open yesterday.
Perfect. The library was open yesterday. Mari, letra H, se prepara Walter con la letra I.
Es que estoy dudando.
It was porque, or it were?
Yes, but I don't know what it is third person, right?
Yes, it is.
But it's not plural because talk about my birthday. It was.
Okay. It was. Fue mi cumpleaños. Okay. It was my birthday on Saturday. Thank you. Walter, letter I, and can you please, Rachel, me ayudas con la última, por favor. Okay, Walter.
Where was they on Sunday?
Okay, they, is plural or singular?
Plural.
Okay, so one more time, please.
Where were they on Sunday?
Excellent. Where were they on Sunday? And the last one, Rachel, is a question.
Were you at school last week?
Were you at school last week? Excellent. So I got a question. Let's see. I'm going to ask to Rachel, please turn on your audio.
Okay.
This is a simple question just to practice the use was and where.
Okay.
Invent. If you want, you can invent. Se prepara Valeria. Rachel, where were you last Saturday, Monday? Where were you Saturday, last Saturday, Monday? Last Saturday morning, my goodness.
Okay, I invent.
Yes,
I
please.
Remember the last week. But I was to visit the doctor and my family were the park, where goes park.
Okay, I was visiting the doctor and my family were in the park. Me gustó, escuché, usaste las dos formas. Okay, finish, excuse me.
Yes, that's
excellent. It. Nice, thank you. Valeria, the same question se prepara Mari. Valeria, where were you last Monday afternoon?
I was in the work. I stay with friends in
San Miguel.
In San Miguel, yes. Okay. He's a greeted.
Okay. Okay, thank you, Vale. So let's see. Mari, the same question to you. Do you remember where were you this last Wednesday morning? Se prepara Walter.
The last Wednesday?
Yes, morning.
I was asleep.
I was sleeping, podemos decir.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I was sleeping all morning. Because was my day
excellent.
Off.
Excellent. Was my day off. Perfect. Walter, please, como usted termina esta dinámica, the same question. Do you remember where were you this last Monday afternoon?
Well, this last Monday, I was at my job. And then I went with my sister to eat pizza.
Excellent. Thank you so much. Exercise number 3. ¿Se acuerdan cuando vimos el pasado? El simple past en forma negativa, o sea, el didn't. Observe la letra A. Tengo el sujeto, I, paréntesis. Recuerden que les mandé un mensaje temprano para que tuvieran listo un tema, porque de ese tema que usted ya me tiene listo, de ahí voy a partir yo en conversación, solo para acordarle, para que lo tenga ahí listo. Puede ser un tema X, de ese tema yo voy a partir a sacarle conversación. Ok, tengo el sujeto I, tengo el verbo go y tengo el complemento to Madrid. Aquí dice I go to Madrid, yo voy a Madrid. El pasado, I didn't go, yo no fui. Pasado negativo, I didn't go to Madrid. Literal B, tengo el sujeto I, tengo el verbo see, que es mirar, y el complemento him yesterday. ¿Cómo pasó esta oración a pasado negativo? O sea,
I didn't see him yesterday.
Excelente, o sea, yo no lo vi a él ayer. I didn't see him yesterday. Christian, can you please help me to choose the next victim? Genesis, Marce, Mari, Andrea, Rachel, Valeria, Walter, o Jasmine?
Rachel.
Rachel, ¿cómo pasó la oración? He marked the homework.
He didn't mark the homework.
Excelente, fácil. He didn't mark the homework. No cambia el verbo. ¿Por qué? Porque si ya tengo yo el auxiliar en pasado, no tiene por qué caer el siguiente verbo en pasado también. Rachel, please, the next victim. Genesis, Marce, Mari, Andrea, Valeria, Walter, o Jasmine.
Christian,
yeah, okay, one more time. Christian, please turn the sentences into past. Bueno, y por cierto, Karina no ha ingresado. Okay, please.
No ha venido. Okay. He's.
Uh-huh.
I think doesn't, right? No?
In past, doesn't is simple negative.
Okay, okay.
In simple present, but okay. I want it in past.
Didn't mother telephone them?
One more time, please. La oración se tiene que quedar. La mamá de él no les llamó a los salvadoreños.
Okay. His mother didn't telephone them.
Okay, let's check. His mother didn't telephone them. Pausa. Okay. Teacher, y telephone que no es un noun. Sí, claro que es un noun, porque obviamente se refiere a un objeto, a un teléfono. Pero telephone, it is a verb too. So, telephone is a noun and sometimes can be replaced as a verb. So,
sería válido traducirlo como que si dijera su madre no los telefoneó.
Exacto, exacto. Hey, telefoneaste a tu amigo. O sea, como dar a entender, le llamaste a tu amigo. Entonces, teléfono viene también siendo una acción de un verbo. Okay. Christian, choose another victim, please.
Rachel, no, don't worry. I'm kidding. Okay. I think Mari.
Okay, Mari, letter E. Ellos no enviaron el reporte. Ajá.
They don't send the report.
Negative in past.
They don't
is present. Ellos no okay. envían.
They didn't.
Uh-huh. Yes.
They didn't send to the report.
Okay. They didn't send. Teacher, y si yo digo they don't, es en presente. Ellos no envían el reporte. O sea, hey, okay. Estoy esperando el reporte. Ellos no lo envían. O sea, como, hey, envíenlo ya. ¿Por qué no lo envían? Ellos no envían el reporte. En pasado, ellos no enviaron el reporte. They didn't send the report. Mari, please. Choose another victim.
Natalie.
Ok, thank you. Andrea, ¿cómo digo él no visitó Londres el año pasado?
He didn't visit London last year.
Excelente, señorita. He didn't, ahí me comí la comida y le puse P. He didn't visit London last year. Repito, visit, no cambia el verbo porque ya tengo el auxiliar en pasado negativo. Andrea, choose the next victim.
Valeria.
Valeria. Ok. Valeria, ¿cómo digo Simon no finalizó el proyecto?
Simon didn't finish the project. I don't know the finish it. No.
No cambia, porque como ya tengo el auxiliar en pasado, no cambia.
Oh, okay.
Simon didn't finish. Ahora bien, teacher, ¿y si yo paso el verbo finish a pasado? Entonces quitémosle el auxiliar. Si yo digo, Simon terminó, Simon finished the project. Ahí normal, Simon terminó el proyecto, Simon finished the project. Pero en pasado negativo para decir, no, Simon no terminó el proyecto, Simon didn't. Solo le agrega el auxiliar este en pasado negativo, ya la pasó en este caso a pasado negativo para decir, Simon no terminó, Simon didn't finish the project. Please, Vale, the last victim, choose one.
Walter.
Okay, Walter. This exercise, where the verb to be. Be careful because we don't need didn't. In this case, change completely. Completely. Como digo, este ejercicio no estuvo difícil.
This exercise.
What is the simple past of verb to be? What is the past of verb to be?
Went. No.
This is the past of go. I go, I went. What? But was or where. Okay. So this exercise was difficult. Este ejercicio estuvo difícil, pero yo lo quiero en negativo. Este ejercicio no estuvo difícil.
This exercise was not difficult.
Excelente. Ok, yo lo puse de forma contractada, pero se puede de las dos formas. This exercise wasn't difficult. Teacher, ¿y por qué en los demás pusimos didn't y en este pusimos was? En este caso, forma negativa, wasn't. Porque cuando usted traduce el verbo to be a pasado, cambia completamente su estructura, como dijo Andrea, ya sea was o were. Ahora bien, was es afirmativa, negativa, wasn't. Where es afirmativa plural, negativa, weren't. Ok, señores, free topic. Créeme que a mí me emociona tanto hablar en inglés con ustedes porque la verdad que son un grupo que yo disfruto estas dinámicas. Ok, teacher, ¿cuál es la dinámica? ¿Cómo era? Que mire, no me acuerdo, no leí el chat. Simple y sencillamente usted tiene que decirme, teacher, this is my topic. Usted comienza a hablar de su tema y de ahí viene la teacher y se mete en su tema, en su conversación, en su explicación. Y comienzo yo a sacar obviamente una conversación en base a eso. Ojo, please, please. It's a conversation, no an interview. No es una entrevista de trabajo que solo yo pregunte. It isn't an interview. It's a free conversation. So, may I choose by myself? ¿Me permiten elegir a mí? Or do we have any volunteer five?
Me, Mari.
Excellent. Thank you. Okay, Mari. Okay.
But honestly, I don't have prepared the topic, but I improve, okay? No, no okay. Problem?
No, my goodness. No, it isn't. So,
okay.
Mari, what's your topic?
Okay, my topic is about travel.
Excellent. I like that I like that topic too. So, yes. Mari, can you please start travel?
Okay. Okay. In my case,
Excuse me, Mari. Can you please help me to choose the next victim para que se vaya preparando psicológicamente?
Okay.
I got a volunteer. Thank you, Rachel. Okay, okay. Rachel, you're going to be the second one. Okay, Mari, excuse me. Go ahead.
Okay, my favorite topic is travel because I like travel. I have an opportunity to travel to any countries. I met Colombia, Brazil, Central America, and other countries. Central America and other countries. But the better of the meet because I worked in the airport and because the job I was the opportunity to to obtain discounts in my travels, but this is the opportunity for meet the other countries. But the teacher, you traveled all country?
Yes, I did. So I had the opportunity to go to different countries.
Oh, wow.
But number one, I remember in 2005, I went to Guatemala.
This is your first travel? Yes. Or
This was the first one.
Okay, my first travel was to Rio de Janeiro, but wow. It's very amazing. Yeah, but you interested in met other countries or maybe only United States?
Well, number one, I had the opportunity to went to Guatemala, and the second, yes, was United States. I had the opportunity to visit Virginia, Washington, and New York with my family. But if I had to choose, I choose New York because I like the city. Virginia is good because it has many parts around it, but I like New York. And Washington, yes, for the White House, because it's one of the most famous places to visit. The third one was Uruguay. I had the opportunity to work in 2006 with the American Embassy. So we went to Uruguay, to be more specific, Montevideo, the city.
Oh, wow.
Like it a lot. I like the culture, I like the people. And the fourth one was Argentina. This was in 2007. Wow. I prefer Uruguay than Argentina. Okay. Yes, but I prefer the Argentina's cuisine. La comida de ahí, I love it. Yes.
I love too.
Yes, I love it.
For this year, do you have any plans to travel?
Yes, I had it, but I got some problems with the, my plan was to go to Bruselas. But the problem is the borders are closed because in my case, I don't got visa because my visa expired. So that is the problem because I need to get again. So I need to apply it again. So the borders from Latin people from Panama to Madrid and then Brussels, the borders are closed for Latin people.
Yes.
So I need to get and apply for my visa again. So I got the idea to go on October, but it wasn't possible. maybe next year.
Good luck. But in my case, maybe travel to the older year because now in my job is a very, very occupied because it's busy because the November and December is a very, very busy because only many people sent the deliveries for the gift or maybe other or the detail, but maybe the next year I travel to Mexico. That maybe.
Excuse me, Mari. In your plans, are you going to spend time with your family on Christmas here in El Salvador or with your family in the United States?
No, maybe we meet with my family in the United States because I don't have I don't believe travel to El Salvador for the time is our busy the time this month, but I don't know.
Okay, stop please, stay there. Can you please, Walter, activemos micrófonos. El tema de Mari, Walter, es travel. Can you please, Walter, invent a question to Mari about traveling? Se prepara Cristian con la misma dinámica. Inventate una pregunta acerca de traveling para que se la hagas a Mari. Okay, Walter, please. What is your question to Mari?
Hi, Mari.
Hello.
Do you like to travel to the... Would you like to go to Norway?
Oh, maybe yes, but because Norway is sound interesting, maybe. And you?
Yes, I like to go to Norway because I like black metal, and Norway is the
Is the crib, como la, es la cuna, digamos. Is the crib.
Is the crib of black metal.
Okay, stop. Thank you, Walter. Nos preparamos con su tema. Please, Christian, what's your question to Mari?
Okay, okay. Hi, Mari.
Hi.
Tell me, do you visit, I don't know, Esquipulas or
Ciudad de
Guatemala? Yeah.
Yes, I like Esquipulas, and I travel in bus. It's a very nice experience. Yes.
Oh, nice.
Do you like visit Esquipulas?
Esquipulas, I don't visit this city, but the
Pausa. Podemos decir I haven't been. No he estado ahí. I haven't been there.
Okay. I haven't been there. But the let me see the calendar. the okay, last Friday nice. of the month I go to Guatemala. And
Guatemala. Antigua Guatemala. Ah, okay.
Antigua, yeah.
Ah, nice. It's very nice.
Yeah, I'm going to visit Antigua for climb the next year.
Stop. Excelente, señores. No. Thank you. Cristian, nos preparamos con tu tema. Okay, thank you, Mari. Okay. Please. Mari, nos quedamos ahí igual. Rachel, are you ready?
Yes, teacher. I don't know how to prepare the topic.
Okay.
But
invent. Don't worry about it. So, Rachel, what is your topic?
My topic is my favorite dance.
My favorite, excuse me? Cuidado con micrófono. Si quieres, topate más el micrófono. Okay, what is your topic, please?
Today I talk about my favorite band.
My favorite band. Okay, Mari, nos preparamos con conversación con Rachel. Okay, Rachel, please, go ahead. Your favorite band.
Okay.
Go ahead.
My favorite band is Bangtan Sonyeondae. That is a Korean band. I love the songs because the songs are so beautiful. The lyrics is so special for the fans. Is they connect with the fans and the artists. And my favorite song is Epiphany. And I don't know, for me, that the best band. And
okay, and stop, please. Okay, Mari, any question, please?
Please repeat the topic.
My favorite band.
Your favorite band. Rachel, do you like a seats or any concert in other country or only in El Salvador?
I don't understand the question. Repeat me.
But the topic is bands, right? Okay. Bands of music, right? Or no?
Yes, it is.
Okay, would you like assist
to go to the concert
in El Salvador or in another country?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I prefer the another country because the El Salvador a small country, and I like will travel to Los Angeles or Korea because for me it's a beautiful country.
Oh, okay.
Okay, Mari, continue, please. It's a conversation with you.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Yes, and I What is your favorite band or what is your favorite music?
My favorite band maybe Maroon 5. And but yes, this is my favorite band, and I like the music, their music, and I would like assist the concert with us, but I don't know what is the calendar for the concerts. Yes.
Okay, stop. Thank you, Mari. Stop. Can you please, Jasmine, activemos micrófono, por favor. Se prepara Génesis. Jasmine, inventemos una pregunta relacionada al tema de Rachel. Her favorite band. Se prepara Génesis.
Okay, teacher.
Okay, Jasmine, please, your question.
Okay.
Are
you ready or not, Jasmine? Don't worry about it. Let me know, please. Are you ready or not?
No, teacher, sorry. Sorry.
Can okay, I please. Participate?
Okay, of course, Christian. Thank you. Se prepara okay. Genesis. Okay, Christian, go.
Hey, Rachel. What's Hi, your Chris. Favorite kind of music?
My favorite kind of music is pop and K-pop because it's a
move. Oh, really? Do you like K-pop?
Yes, I like. And what
do
is
you like, do you like BTS? Kind of
yes, I love.
Wow, my but, sister too.
Yeah, right,
she's exactly. crazy for BTS.
You don't, Christian?
No, I don't.
What is your kind of favorite music?
My favorite kind of music, I don't know, maybe rock, rap, reggaeton chuco.
On the floor?
On the floor, right, yeah.
Okay, stop, please, because I got more volunteers too, so Genesis, okay. Thank you so much, thank you. Genesis, what is your question to Rachel?
Your favorite band, what is your favorite song?
My favorite band is BTS.
But yeah, Genesis is asking, what's your favorite song?
My favorite, I don't know, it's a lot of songs because they are maybe, I don't remember, but maybe 13 albums and it's a lot of.
Okay.
I prefer micro. Uh-huh.
Okay. Excelente. Thank you so much, Rachel. Miren, yo los pauso porque obviamente tengo más gente y no quiero que la gente se me vaya a dormir. So, do we have any volunteer or may I choose? ¿Me permiten elegir a mí? May I choose by myself? 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, Rachel, please choose one. Genesis, Marce, Andrea, Valeria, Walter, o Jasmine?
Genesis.
Okay, thank you, Rachel. Genesis, what is your topic? If you want, you can invent. Okay.
My favorite song?
No. Your topic to discuss for the conversation.
I don't have a topic, maybe...
Invent.
Serious?
Serious. Excellent topic. Okay. Da tu introducción. Walter, nos preparamos con conversación. Her favorite topic is serious. Okay, Genesis, go ahead.
Well, I think the serious... need a good drama for Catch Me Right Now. I watch two series, and the first one is You, and the last one is Skip Game.
Mm-hmm.
The first time I don't like Skip Game, but I have an opportunity to see, and I like this series. My favorite series is a Turkish series. It's a Twist of Fate. This series is finished, but I can watch this series every time and it seems boring for me. I love so much this series.
Okay, please, Genesis, do you have any question to Walter to continue the conversation?
And Walter, which was your favorite series?
Well, I think it depends about the genre. For example, about a sitcom, my favorite series is Married with Children. And it's like the 80s, 90s. I think I like so much that I download all the episodes and I watch it from once in a while.
Mm-hmm.
And what is your favorite sitcom series, like about comedy?
About comedy, I don't see too much series about comedy, but maybe I don't remember the name, but I think it's El Club de los Cuervos. I don't remember too much this name.
So do you don't like comedies? Do you like dramas?
I like comedies, but I prefer drama. How do you say intriga, teacher?
The intrigues. Intrigues.
Intrigue series.
Okay. For that kind, I like thriller, right? I like Prison Break.
Good, nice.
Maybe, yeah. I can remember. And do you like what do you recommend for me to see this? I
to think watch
that
it.
You like to watch it. I hear like you say Turkey.
Oh, it depends. If you like dramas in Turkish series, maybe I recommend you Herkay. And it depends of you like of the drama or comedy, romantic or actions. But Turkish series is good.
Okay.
I can catch.
Okay, excuse me. Thank you so much, Genesis. Okay, thank you, Walter. So, Genesis, can you please help me to choose the next big thing? Oh, I don't know if do we have any volunteer. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Choose one, please, Genesis. I got Andrea, Valeria, Marce. Well, Marce is working. I don't know if she's ready. Jasmine, Christian, I think so. Yes, Christian. Choose one, please, Genesis.
Christian.
Okay. Hi, Christian. Ready?
Yes.
Excellent. Claro, can you please? Excellent. Always ready. Se prepara Valeria para conversación con Christian. Christian, what's your topic?
I don't know, teacher. Maybe goals in life.
Wow, that is a really interesting
topic. Do you have goals in your life, teacher?
I got many. Well, not many, not too much, but the first one is I would like to have my bilingual kindergarten. Yes. So this is one of my dreams. It's not a goal, it's a dream. But talking about a goal, I would like to learn French next year. So this is my next challenge. And you?
Oh, me too. I consider French for their language.
Yes.
In this afternoon.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Do you have any idea?
Interesting.
If there any academy?
I don't know. I
please don't say European academy.
No,
because...
no, no.
No, no, it doesn't work.
I don't have either.
Okay, but French is.
But
I like
I
French.
I consider learn French or or German.
German
is interesting too.
People said German is easier than French. I don't know.
Oh,
I don't know.
No, teacher. I hear German is very difficult.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
why? The grammar or the difficult. Pronounce?
All.
All.
Good. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, it's very difficult. Maybe the normal people learn German in... I don't know, 1 or 2 years. Yeah, because the pronunciation is so hard.
I don't have any idea about German, but about French, I was trying to learn 6 months ago. So I stopped it because I'm a busy woman. But the second reason was the pronouns. It's like with your throat. It's really difficult for me. It's really difficult for me. Maybe Italian. I like Italian too.
People said Italian Italian is easier in comparation with other idiom because
it is.
They say it's the bad Spanish.
Oh really?
Right? Yeah. My cousin learned Italian in I don't know 6 months, I think.
Wow. I got a friend too. She speaks a very, very good Italian, but the problem is the writing, the handwriting.
Oh.
Yes. So, well, languages in general are good. In general, they are good. But nowadays, to be more specific, in El Salvador, it's necessary to learn at least 2 or 3 languages more besides Spanish, right?
Yeah.
So, if you want to learn a language, do it. Because it's really important if you want to get a better salary, if you want to get more opportunities at job, right?
Yes, I want this because I need more money.
Everyone needs.
Yeah.
Everyone needs. So stop it, please. Wait a minute. Valeria, okay. Do you have any questions to Christian about languages, about goals in life?
Pregunte.
Ask me, please.
Okay. What goals have you set yourself this year and the other year? Year?
I don't know.
For example, in December, okay. What are you the goals?
Okay.
Be on diet.
yeah.
No, this is my. Okay.
Okay.
For November, my goal is to travel to Guatemala for climb the Acatenango volcano. It's my favorite goal for this year. It's a good experience. It's amazing, the view in the top of the volcano, and it's funny. I going to go with my friend Fernando and my cousin Jaime. For December, I don't know. I feel like to look my family from United States. They visit the country for Christmas.
Okay.
And I consider this is my goals for this year.
Okay, yeah. Thank you so much, Christian. Thank you, Vale. Can you please, Christian, choose the next victim? Who's missing? Valeria, Marce, please let me know if you're ready to participate too, please. So please, Christian, Andrea, Jasmine, Walter, or Valeria?
Valeria.
Okay, thank you, Christian. Hi, Vale. Are you ready?
Hi. Yes.
Okay, nice. Andrea, nos preparamos para conversación. Please. Valeria, what's your topic?
Okay. I'll be honest, I don't prepare the topic. But okay. I think about the one. And okay, in the... Is it important to practice sport?
Okay, the importance to practice sports. La importancia sport. De practicar deporte. Y me llega porque la Andrea creo que está yendo al gimnasio, así que muy bien. Andrea, nos preparamos. Okay, Valeria, please. The importance of practice sports. Go ahead.
In my opinion, is it important practicing sport because is the better the body? Because it dexterity and you have fun living the stress of the worries that have the moment, for example, work or problem in the home or other experience sad in the life.
Okay, stop, please. Andrea, please, your question.
Do you think sport is more important than food?
Wow, good question.
In the
quitémonos el D, vale. El D, okay. El D, ajá, okay. De un, ajá, quitémonos la muletilla, okay.
Repeat the question, please.
What is more important for you, sports or food? To practice sports or food? Okay, why?
The both, because...
Quitémonos el D, solo digamos both.
Yes, both.
Okay.
Because help in the body, sport or eat. Because you practice sport, but you how do you say Davis?
You have to
eat good.
Vale, please, any question to Andrea?
Okay. Andrea, do you practice sport? No gym. Other.
No.
Why?
Because I don't have time.
I don't have time. Why? What do you do?
In all day, I have a study.
I have to study
or cuando tengo
when I have time.
When I have time. I like to go to the mall.
I like to go to the shopping. Wow.
And yes.
Stop, Andrea, please. Any question to Valeria? Please, 5, 4, 3, 2, action.
Escucha. Sí.
Yes, please.
Sí. How many do you practice?
How many days?
¿Cuánto tiempo lleva practicando? ¿Cómo sería?
How much time? Porque es uncountable.
How much time do you practice sport in your life?
Life? Siento como que estoy en nivel 1, niñas. Ajá, ok.
No, yo sí estoy allá.
Yes, please, Valeria.
Ok. I was in the study, the school. I practiced volleyball and basket.
Every day.
Because I was in the
in the soccer team, in the baseball
team. In the soccer team. In the moment, I practiced ping pong at work.
It is easy to practice it, to play it.
And not easy, but depends do practice.
Are you an expert? For example,
no.
No, I'm not.
Why not? In the moment. maybe in the most, for example, 5, 6 or the other years.
Okay.
Vale, well, what sport do you recommend?
maybe you go a run?
Go running.
It's okay. You go to the gym.
Yes. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ladies.
Okay.
Algunas niñas, qué barbaridad. Okay. Thank you so much, Valeria. Please help me to choose the next one. Jasmine, Walter, or bueno, Marcia no sé si está trabajando. Jasmine o Walter, please. O Andrea, please.
Andrea.
Okay, thank you. Andrea, what's your topic?
Okay. ¿Cómo?
What's your topic?
Okay. I am going to talk about my favorite singer.
Favorite singer. Jasmine, nos preparamos con preguntas. Okay, Andrea, please, go ahead.
My favorite singer is Alex Campos. He has 2 children. He has 44 years old.
Mm-hmm.
He starts singing he was 10 years old.
He came
to El Salvador for concerts, and I went to see the concert, and I remember it was before pandemic.
Yes, it is. It was. Yes, it was. Excuse me. Okay, stay there, please. Jasmine, please.
Okay.
Her favorite singer. Okay, Jasmine, ready?
Yes.
Okay, yes, any question, please. Any question, inventor.
Yes. What is your favorite song of Alex Campos?
Excellent.
My favorite song is Al Taller del Maestro.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's
it's a beautiful song.
It's beautiful. It's angelica. ¿Cómo es? Angelicals. No sé.
Angelical? Yes.
Angelicals.
Okay. Uh-huh. Yes. Please continue, ladies. It's a conversation. My goodness. Okay. For example, Jasmine, do you like Alex Campos or do you prefer to listen other singers?
Do you know the music?
Of Alex Campos.
Of Alex Campos.
Okay. Yes, yes, I like Alex Campos. Some of the songs with her, with him.
Mm-hmm.
I like very much.
Do you like Christian music, Jasmine?
Yes, I love Christian music. Jesús Adrián Romero.
Sí, metete, hijo. O sea, pero, metas en la conversación. Cuando ustedes vean que alguien para o algo, ahí metas. Ok. Uh-huh.
Okay. Jesús Adrián Romero, yes. I love this song.
Ah, yes.
I'm the fruit.
I enjoy.
Mucha the group of the Hillsong. Are you like bands? Christian bands?
Do you like
Christian bands?
Hillsong is Christian, a really good band.
Yes, Hillsong. I don't know the music. Really, no lo conozco mucho.
For example, band Rojo. This is a band
from Mexico. Yes.
A music Rojo. Spanish.
Yes. Rojo, yeah. Yes.
For example, my favorite songs of the band Rojo. It's a No Me Soltarás. It's a beautiful song.
No Me Soltarás. Yes. Uh-huh. And also. Yes. Do you know Tercer Cielo?
Mm-hmm.
Ah, yes.
Yes.
What's your opinion?
In my case, Tercer Cielo, I don't like much. I don't know. And I prefer Rojo or Hillsong.
Okay, stop. Thank you so much, Andrea. Okay, so Jasmine, are you ready with your topic or may I continue with Walter?
Okay, for me, teacher.
Okay, excellent. So what is your topic? Let me see. Okay, Walter, nos preparamos con conversación. Ya con ustedes dos termino. Yes, Jasmine, please, what's your topic?
Okay, I'm sorry, teacher, but my topic is about the food.
Food, good. Okay, go ahead.
One favorite food for me is a Mexican food, okay, and China food. But I love everything food and fast food too. I eat every day in my house. Food house, normal. But some weekends I go and eat out of my house with my mm-hmm. daughter.
Okay.
I think the healthy food is the better for our life.
Yes, it is, but most people don't like it.
Okay. Eat healthy food is necessary for a good health. And not sick or no enfermarnos.
No, uh-huh. Don't get sick.
Not get sick.
Okay, Walter, please, any question?
What is your favorite restaurant? About Chinese food?
Oh, okay, Chinese food. My favorite restaurant is for years. It's a Dynasty. It's a very, very good food.
What kind of restaurant it is? I mean, is a Italian restaurant, Mexican, or what?
It's Chinese food, right?
It's a Chinese restaurant?
Yes.
Okay, please continue.
Yes, it's a Chinese restaurant. Walter, and for you, what do you like about the food?
Well, I think that my favorite kind of food is Italian food because I like pizza and pastas. But also I like the, like do you say, I like fast food. I like Chinese. But I prefer, if I have to choose, I always choose pizza.
And oh yes, margarita pizza, I love.
The pineapple is good too.
The Hawaiian.
Yes, it is a Hawaiian pizza.
And what is your favorite restaurant about pizza? Because with my sister, we go to, we have at least, so I need more options to prove I need pizza. Can you give me a...
any recommendation?
Any recommendation, please?
Oh, good, okay. Okay, and the pizza, I recommend a restaurant San Martin. It's a good pizza.
I like the cafe there.
Yes. The San Martin, it's a specialty in dessert of coffee, but the food is a very good.
The food is very good. Okay, the last question to Jasmine, please, Walter.
Well, what kind of food you can eat 3 times a day?
In my case, pupusas.
Another one that you can eat, but it was not pupusas.
I love, for example, in the Mexican food, I love the gringas.
Okay.
Yeah. Am I going to eat the gringas and in the week, for example, Monday or Tuesday? And I love.
If you like the Mexican food, do you like hot? The chili and hot sauces.
The spicy food?
Yeah, the spicy food, that was.
Spicy, not much. I prefer no most spicy, más normal.
The normal?
Mm-hmm. No more spicy.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you, Walter.
Thank you, Jasmine. Thanks, you too. Okay, so Walter, are you ready with your topic?
Yes, I'm ready.
So, do you want to have the conversation with your teacher or with someone else? It's your option.
With both.
Okay, so first one, I'm going to, okay, with your teacher, and the second, I'm going to choose another one. Okay, Walter, okay. What's your topic?
Well, my topic, I think it was music, but I can talk about hobbies.
Hobbies, okay. Well, please, yeah. Go ahead.
Well, I think that hobbies are very necessary, because you need to switch off about your job,
mm-hmm.
and you can do another things, so you can relax or do things that do you like. I think that my favorite hobbies are listening to music and play video games.
Okay.
This month, I bought a new console.
I got a question, Walter. For example, yes. Is there any hobby that you don't like to practice?
Yeah. No.
For example, in my case, I don't like to draw. For me, I don't have that ability. I prefer to color.
Ah, okay. No, I can draw.
But about hobbies, is there anyone that you don't like it?
Well, I think that is, it is a hobby is because you like, because I think that draw for me, I can consider it like a hobby.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Because I don't like to draw. I think that you can, a hobby is something that do you like and you like to practice.
Uh-huh, for example, mm-hmm.
For me, a hobby is play video games, but I know that you don't like to play video games, so that was not a hobby for you.
Hey, yes, I don't like to play video games. In my case, I don't have any idea about it. So some people said play video games is a sport. So do you agree?
Yeah, they call it e-sport, but it's finally I think that it's a sport.
Okay, stop, please. Stop there. Christian, can you please, cada uno, invénteme una pregunta en base al tema de Walter. Y ya con eso voy finalizando. Christian, please, your question. Se prepara Genesis.
Okay, sorry. Can you remind me the topic of Walter?
Hobbies.
Hobbies, okay. Hey, Walter. Do you like football or basketball or I don't know other sport
as a hobby? Mm-hmm.
I like to watch all kind of sport. I like to watch
only watch
yes, but to practice only practice? basketball.
Okay, yes. Are you a good basketball player?
I can consider it too good, but not too bad.
people say to me, Walter is Michael Jordan. Wow, really? Walter is Michael Jordan? Wow, nice.
Hey, is Michael Jordan alive or he passed away?
He's alive.
He's alive. Ah, okay. Okay, thank you, Christian. Please, Genesis. What's your question to Walter? Se prepara Andrea. Thank you, Genesis. Are you ready? Please, 5, 4, excellent.
No, I'm not. I don't have a question.
Okay, invent. Yes, the topic is hobby. It's a very easy topic. Please, invent just one.
How hobby you recommend me?
Good.
Listening to music, but for example, I try to discover new bands or genres.
In English or in Spanish?
Yeah, it doesn't matter. Okay. I listen to music, English, French, and another language that I don't know they exist.
Wow, nice. Thank you, Genesis. Andrea, please. Your question. Se prepara Rachel.
What activities do you do to relax?
Yes, which activities relax you? Or makes you feel relaxed?
Listening to music. When I go on traffic, I need to put some music.
Do you put the radio or do you put your CDs?
I never listen radio. I listen albums from Spotify or albums that I download from internet.
Mm-hmm. Excellent, nice, okay. Rachel, please, what's your question? Se prepara Valeria.
For you, what is better, the books or the music?
Music. I think that.
Why?
Because I can read. I like to read books. Well, I try to read books, but sometimes I don't read. I don't read all days, but for music, I listen music every day.
Sometimes the books are so bored, but another books are so very interesting.
Yes.
And
usually
never try to learn read the book.
Excuse me.
Can you please repeat?
Never try read the any book.
Any yes. Book about what?
I don't know how to say lo que sea, whatever.
Yes, it is.
Yes. And if I can maybe, or comedy or drama or romantic, then try read any book.
Yes. I like to read books, for example. Yes, I like novels. For example, one of my favorite books, it was, I don't know how to say, the La Guerra de Loto.
The Lotus War.
The Lotus Wars is, there are three books about this girl that she can talk with animals. It's like Japan. It's Japan. This one is in Japan, but it's a steampunk.
Sure, the Lotus is not the women in the Japan about the feet. It's a little bit, no. The feet?
No.
Or what about the book?
The Lotus War. Mm-hmm.
The Lotus War is I think that I like is because I like Japanese culture, and this book is about the Japanese culture, about the Isin Shogun and all that things summarize, but they also mix it with the steampunk. Steampunk is, I don't know if you see Mad Max. That's a steampunk.
Okay, stop. Okay, thank you, Walter, for the time. Excuse me, may I interrupt you? So, Valeria, are you ready? I'm going to finish with you, Vale.
Yes.
Okay, please, go ahead. Your question.
Okay. My question for you, Walter, is what song can you listen all the time and you don't get bored?
Nice question.
What song?
Yes. Which song can you listen every day and never get boring?
I think that it's sometimes when I wake up, I have a song in my mind, so I can listen that song all day. For example, this week I listen to an album. I was listening again an album that's called The Dark Ride, about it's from Halloween, and they have a song they call The Departure. So I listen to this song like 3 or 5 times a day this week.
Okay, nice. Excellent. Thank you, my dearest students. I'm so sorry for the time. Well, it just 5 minutes. It's just 5 minutes more. Have a really nice weekend. Enjoy with your friends and family. And see you this coming Monday. Good night, people. Bye. Night, night.
Bye. Night, teacher. Bye.
Thank you.
Night, everyone.
Thank you.